Okay. A bit of a disclaimer, I haven't played this character in about a week. Yeah, we'll say a week. In the meantime, I've been playing normal characters, low-level characters, and I just did, between yesterday and today, a bit of a practice with some level 1 hardcore characters. And didn't go well, exactly. So, I'm kind of putting the patch before the injury. And going in with zero confidence. But if I die, it's just restart and try again. So here we go. I don't even remember what equipment I had at this point. Okay, level 31. I'm leveling up vitality and endurance mostly. I have the trick sword plus 2. I'm gonna need more purple moss. I think I'm just gonna run back and take a bit more. No, but the Estus should last. Oh wait, this is a medium roll. I'm medium rolling here. Yeah, medium rolling. I think I'm gonna switch to a fast roll. So I need 45, 22.5 should be. So let's see. Still not enough. Heavy crossbow, but that's quite a bit of weight. Yeah, I'm still with our fast roll. To go. Kill it. Yeah, I'm supposed to kill Queelag with the great sword before starting dumping points into dexterity for the boulder size sword. But I don't know if that's gonna work. I mean, I never tried it that way. I'm kind of afraid of the crabs these little bastards do. Toxic. Oh, forgot about this guy. Okay, kill it fast. No. Cure poison. I have to run away. I'm gonna get ganked by the sides if I stay there. Just one of them came to me, she'll be another one, or there she, well, there he, I don't know, he, she, not sure about this one. By the way, Blighttown still has a performance hit on PC versions. I mean, my computer is not particularly powerful, but it's not a slow PC either, but still I can maintain 60 FPS and streaming at the same time here. Okay, so now I have to collect the Yaito. But going for the Yaito now, it's not really trouble, but if I for some reason fail the jump, I'm gonna land down there, lose a lot of HP because of the fall, and there's two guys down there are gonna jump on me quite enthusiastically, so I'm gonna actually take another round first. humanity down here. I'm actually getting a bit nervous. Like, I'm gonna fall. Like, do a dumb mistake. Get the feeling, and I don't want to dig my own grave saying that, but it's what it feels like. Those were the guys that may gank you if you fall, if you fail the jump for the Yaito. So I know that's taken care of. I can just go and try the jump. If I fail, I won't die anyway. Just try again, heal up, try again. I hope the stream is, the video is not too choppy at the moment, because it's actually quite chubby for me. I'm not used to the 30 FPS. And I failed the jump, just as I thought it will happen. So glad I came and killed him again. So glad I killed him before trying to jump. Say 10,000. I think I'm gonna upgrade the dragon, the tracer once more with the dragon scale that's at the bottom. That's in the center of the swamp. Let's see if I shall drop my. HP increases greatly until 30, then starts getting a bit of diminishing returns until 40, and then more diminishing returns until 50, and once you hit 50, there's no point upgrading vitality anymore, because you get 8 or less HP per point in vitality, so it's pretty much a big waste. I think I'm gonna just hit the first milestone at 30. I should start pumping dexterity. 16, okay, 15, so I got enough. Okay, so now, Blighttown is hard the first time you're here, but it's actually not such a big maze. It's more the cliffs and ledges fall. Annoying enemies like this one, or the toxic sniper that's right there. I can't see it, but it's right there. So this particular part, you have to just keep going there, start shooting, keep going, and fight these guys over here if you want to. Oh, they both. That's nice. Now, you can always avoid the enemies and try to kill them, but you have to be aware that they're gonna chase you, like, or jump on you, or whatever. Nope. Don't play with the camera, does that? There's one guy coming. Oh, come on. Get up, get up. There should be one coming from other place, I think. Okay, so we got one poison every. I don't remember the name of these guys. These guys. Just avoid the first one. They die in one kid. Here we have the second sniper, the toxic sniper that was shooting at us after the bonfire. This parasite that does absolutely nothing from this side, so it's just crack, crack, crack. And power within. there's the whip. The whip is actually kind of a unique weapon. To take it safely, just jump towards the wall here. So you rebound on the wall, land safely there, you won't fall in. Same here, just walk here and that will make you land safely. And this is where you are coming from if you follow the normal path, so I need to go up there again. Or maybe just to clear the fall off. Just for the sake of completion. Just for being thorough. You can see the other side. Right there. If you notice, I'm not running at all, because at the moment I'm having quite low frame rate. It just got video doesn't end up being that it's choppy, or at least watching is not a torture on this part, or you get it. So I don't want to risk it. Sniper that somebody started shooting. You can use the spider shield here as well, since the spider shield has pretty good poison resistance. It just blocks the charge. Okay, so here we're gonna get poisoned no matter what. And we have, I have to collect a lot of stuff. Let's start. Not gonna go to the great hollow yet because one, I don't want to fall right now, and two, there's no point going there at this point. I mean, I need to do it to complete the run, but there's nothing really there that's gonna help me at this point. Actually, should kill all these guys since I'm here. See if I can get large damage charge on them. So if I just have one chance to kill these guys, I shouldn't really avoid them. But they'll kind of put too many together though. Yeah. Come on, jump, continue, jump with me. Thank you. And they didn't drop anything. Damn it. Oh, you're still alive. Nothing at all, just the queen. Did I miss any? I shall kill all these guys. Got one chance for that. With the stats I have and the ones I'm leveling, the breakpoint for switching the tracer for the boulder sensor should be near +7 or +8, so I can't really use it for the fight with Queelag, because I haven't gone to Andre after getting the large ember. Oh, that was bad. Oh, she's still not dead. But they feel like not really focusing on it. Okay. I'm going for a chill here. Why this lobby run? I think I shouldn't be actually locking on. Yeah, here comes explosion. But you don't do that, the dialogues. I could get the egg and do that, but just yeah, just gonna kill it. Sorry, engine, really, really sorry. I'm really sorry. Didn't mean to at all. Oh, this little guy is right. Annoying little ones. Annoying, by the way. run back. Ever ended up in San Fortress, so I'm about to reach my previous best point. And no, I didn't die to the swinging side access thingy traps. I actually fell, and it was really dumb. I knew that fall would kill me, and I just didn't use the other slats for I don't know what reason. Everything is taken from Blighttown, upper part, this one, Queelag's the main. The Great Hollow I'm gonna visit later on. Not much point getting there. I said I was going to go to the catacombs for the kindle, for the rite of kindling, but I have to go there anyway, so making two passes seems like bit unproductive, so I'm just gonna when I go for Nido, I'm gonna go for the rectangle, so it's gonna be actually pretty late in the game. I like to go to Nido last, not because he's harder, it's just I want to go with the Sunlight Mega already on my position. Dead Dragon 2, I'm just gonna kill it later. This is range weaponry when I actually start using it. Probably the fire spell. I already checked this. Oh, I think I got the ember I can give to the blacksmith. Just because, really.
Well, this is on you. You haven't lost your head. And more importantly, you're free. How on earth? Well, I shouldn't cry. I'm Rickett Villain. I was once an established smith. Look at me now. Can you believe it? What is it? Have you? Oh no. Don't worry. I've no intention of escaping. It's safe here. I can't bear the thought of going hollow out there. Although, I must admit, I've not much to occupy myself. How about this? I could forge your weapons, albeit with rather minimal tools. I'll show you what made me the best in Vinheim. Come back soon. Smithing helps soothe my nerves. Don't let me wither away out of idleness.
Wait, I have chamber or not? Or chamber. Oh, I don't have the enchanted chamber. I'm just wasting time here. Not this way. Oops. Oh my god. I almost just did that. I almost just jumped to my death. Oh, that was... Oh, that was close. That was too close.
I am the primordial serpent, King Seeker Frapp. Close friend of the great chosen undead who has rung the bell of awakening. I wish to elucidate your fate. Do you seek such enlightenment? Very well. Then I am pleased to share. Chosen undead, your fate is to succeed the great Lord Gwyn, so that you may link the fire, cast away the dark, and undo the curse of the undead. To this end, you must visit Anor Londo and acquire the Lord Vessel. I am pleased to see you well. Is it something urgent?
Let's see what we can get from this guy. I think I can trade that with Snuggling. Yeah, I'm already training this one. Yeah, I'm not gonna use elemental weapons. No. Thank you. these guys are still here. Why?
Oh, my guest, I will be... So, I'm afraid I will be saying goodbye soon. It was a pleasure. Oh, hello. Miracles, I presume? Yes, I know.
No.
Come again. The effectiveness of the teachings depend upon your faith.
You are undead as well. Then we've no time to fraternize. I have my mission and you no doubt have yours. We must not let this curse overcome us.
Today.